The following wrestling exhibition requires discretionary viewer participation. George the Animal Steele returns to action this week on Championship Wrestling. And joining George the Animal Steele will be the likes of Professor Taru Tanaka. Also scheduled to be on hand, a special feature match, as we promised you last week, where you'll be seeing the tag team combination of Baron Von Raschke, his tag team partner Stan the Man Stasiak, opposing Tony Garea and Larry Zbyszko. Hello, everyone. My name is Vince McMahon. In addition to the matches already mentioned, we'll also be taking a look at superstar Billy Graham, the current Worldwide Wrestling Federation heavyweight champion. Indeed, superstar Graham defeated Bruno Sammartino in Baltimore, Maryland, Saturday night, April the 30th, for the championship. We're going to take a look at some of the films in the coming weeks of that extraordinary championship match. And now we may take a look at the grueling confrontation that ensued in Baltimore. Superstar chose not to enter the battle royal here in Baltimore, but rather to take on Bruno heads up one-on-one, and the Maryland State Athletic Commission gave him the shot, and here we are right here tonight. Sammartino back to the corner. Graham exhibiting some of that tremendous power he possesses. Bruno shaking it off a little bit. Set to tie up with Superstar again. Graham again shoving Bruno back to the corner. And Superstar says nothing. So Graham has this. The referee will break it up. Graham wants to break the momentum of Sammartino, apparently. Voluntarily on the outside, Sammartino coming over, wants to have that Superstar. Graham now rolls back underneath the bottom rope. Superstar wants to beg off just a bit.
Unquestionably, ladies and gentlemen, that was a grueling part of the match you saw. Unquestionably, it was a historical match, a controversial match, as we will be showing you in the future weeks to come, more segments of the championship change that took place in Baltimore, Maryland on the 30th of April. And of course, later on, we will have a non-title match right here in this ring. Superstar Billy Graham will appear as Worldwide Wrestling Federation champion. Right now, though, let's go up to the ring. Let's go to the first match involving Bob Backlund, who is about ready to enter the ring at the moment.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another action-packed card of Championship Wrestling. These matches are sanctioned and supervised by the State Athletic Commission. Chief Deputy Commissioners in attendance are Jimmy Mina and Sam Skaversky. The timekeeper at the bell is J.P. Mina. Your referees for this hour are Dick Worley, Dusty Feldbaumer, and John Stanley. And I'm your ring announcer, Gary Michael Capetta. The first match in the ring is all set for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing, in the corner to my right, from Minneapolis, Minnesota, weighing 244 pounds, Jan Nelson. And his opponent, 231 pounds from Princeton, Minnesota, Bob Backlund.
Bob Backlund, unquestionably one of a kind, an extraordinary athlete to say the least. Backlund getting set to take on rugged Jan Nelson, and here we go. Bob Backlund set the tie up again with Jan Nelson.
back an individual possessing tremendous scientific knowledge of wrestling. Nice hip roll takedown. Backlund just appears to be playing around here with his opponent. Nice move on the part. Oh, nice reversal just like that. Bob Backlund turns things right back around. Reversal by Jan Nelson. A double reverse there. As we remarked through the weeks, one of the most outstanding things about Bob Backlund, if there is any one outstanding thing, is his lightning-like quickness. Unquestionably, I believe the quickest athlete in professional wrestling today. Not to discount his enormous physical powers in the strength department. Full Nelson applied by Jan Nelson, and a nice reversal again there by Mr. Bob Backlund. Look at that maneuver, would you? Seldom seen on championship wrestling. Back on his feet again. Jan Nelson now will test his strength, locking fingers there with Mr. Bob Backlund. Muscles rippling in the back of Backlund. Is Backlund, look at this. Whoa, my goodness. Arm drag, takedown. Backlund all over him, another one. Nelson all over that ring. Backlund, one of the few wrestlers that can do it all. And he's doing it here this week on Championship Wrestling. Backlund back to the corner by Jan Nelson. Referee there, and there was a clean break, probably only because Backlund had his arm cocked to reverse any effort that might be forthcoming from Jan Nelson. Look at that, unbelievable speed. Nelson, a moment ago, reached for the foot, tried the hair, still reaching. Backlund holding on to the hammerlock, applying a little more pressure now. Nelson says, no, I won't give up, asked quickly by the referee. Nelson makes his way over, hooks the rope. We'll have a clean break. Backlund, a fine young gentleman. If you get the opportunity, you really should meet the young man. He is really sensational outside of the ring as well as in. Nelson got in the kick to the abdominals, but it didn't have too much effect there on Bob Backlund, who hooked the leg and took him down. Nelson on his feet, pushes Backlund against the ropes. Elbow certainly makes its mark. Another one to the midsection. Elbow smash across the back of the neck. Another one hammering down hard now. Jan Nelson. Nelson shoves Backlund to the ropes. Hit it up. Oh, what a backdrop. Down for the cover. Referee with one, and that's all they can get on battling Bob Backlund. Backlund back to his feet, perhaps not. No, nice reversal. You can see it coming. Backlund in control here. Reverse ball, Nelson, here we go. Takedown suplex. Nice maneuver on the part of Bob Backlund. Jan Nelson dazed. Backlund has him high in the air. Amazing feat of strength practiced by Bob Backlund. Nelson passing down across the knee. Backlund covering him. Referee down with two, and it's all over. Backlund One of the most extraordinary wrestlers we've seen in a long, long time. He is really amazing.
The time of the match, 5 minutes, 32 seconds. Here's your winner, Bob Backlund.
Bob Backlund, a happy young man with a lot of reason to be happy. Undefeated thus far on Championship Wrestling. Let's take a look at several segments we saw in the match. Here the full Nelson was applied. Here a most unusual hold there. Most unusual escape applied by Backlund. Nelson, to his amazement, finds himself going over. Backlund had other fine moves in the match. As we take a look now, Bob Backlund continuing all the way through the match to dominate it over Jan Nelson. And here, way up there, Backlund, imagine a leverage and a momentum as Nelson goes flying across the other side of the ring. And of course, from there, ladies and gentlemen, it was Bob Backlund on his way to another victory. Here, the amazing feat of strength again. Only Backlund can do this. Down to the knee, on to victory. We'll be back as we continue with Professor Taru Tanaka.
Ladies and gentlemen, this attraction is all set for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing, in the corner to my left, weighing 221 pounds from Puerto Rico, Johnny Rivera. And his opponent, led by his manager, the Hollywood fashion plate, Freddie Blassie. Returning to this arena after an extended absence, weighing 285 pounds from Hiroshima, Japan, Professor Taru Tanaka.
Professor Taru Tanaka, built like a freight train, as Tanaka set for action against Johnny Rivera. Fred Blassie on the outside of the ring. Perhaps now we'll have the wrestlers tying up. Rivera's ready for action. Blassie shooing Rivera back, apparently Tanaka objecting to something. Oh, now Tanaka bowing. And we'll go through, it appears, some sort of a ritual. Chasing the evil spirits away or what have you. Look at the size of those shoulders, would you? Tanaka built like a Sherman tank. That's exactly what he is. He is something else indeed. Appeared to be tucking a little bit of that salt left over into his tights. Tanaka, a master of the martial arts, as well as being a master of the American catch-as-catch-can style. A quick little karate chop there to the kidney. Tanaka with Rivera gets the top rope. And again, working with more karate, the referee apparently taking exception to the moves of Toro Tanaka. Forearm smash by Rivera moves Tanaka back, but only a bit. Tanaka from behind. Tanaka keeping his obvious chokehold from our vantage point away from the vantage point of the referee. Head first to the turnbuckle goes Johnny Rivera. Fred Blassie shouting instructions to Professor Taru Tanaka.
McMahon, what have you got to say now? I have Professor Toru Tanaka in Blassie's army, the greatest Japanese wrestler of all time. Now, in Blassie's army, I guarantee you, we're going all the way this time, McMahon. All the way.
Right across the unmistakable voice of Fred Blassie. At the moment, Johnny Rivera coming. Well, a couple of quick chops there, and Professor Tanaka right in control once again. Tanaka, who is listed here this week, over 270 pounds. And as you can see, he is really put together and knows how to use all that weight to his advantage. Tanaka trying to rearrange the spinal column there of Johnny Rivera, maybe doing a good job of it. From our vantage point, it certainly looks like he is. Head first again to the turnbuckle was Johnny Rivera. That has been quite a lengthy absence between appearances of Professor Toru Tanaka. Some years ago, Professor Tanaka ranked among the top of contenders for the Worldwide Wrestling Federation. From the looks of things, he may be right back up there very shortly as Rivera tries to turn things around there, but unfortunately, Tanaka has things well at hand. Rivera coming right back. He's a game, young man. Side headlock, hair pull, and Tanaka has him in the corner. Not the place to be. Karate chop to the midsection. Now one to the side of the head. Rivera backs him up a bit more. Rivera to the ropes. Try to body block him. Couldn't move him, but just a little bit. Tanaka swung him over. Ooh, back kick. Tanaka with what appears to be that Japanese sleeper hold. Snapped him down to the canvas. Wow. Count of one, count of two, it's all over. So round of boos here. Greet Professor Toru Tanaka and his triumphant return over Johnny Rivera.
The time of the match, 5 minutes, 27 seconds. Here's your winner, Professor Toru Tanaka.
Professor Toru Tanaka, massive as ever, and I believe looking better than ever. Tanaka victorious here after quite a lengthy absence. One more chop will do it. We'll be back as we continue with more wrestling action in a moment.
Wrestling fans, the next attraction is all set for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing, in the corner to my right, weighing 287 pounds from Cincinnati, Ohio, Frank Monroe. And his opponent, from Ardmore, Oklahoma, 244 pounds, the co-holder of the World Tag Team Championship, Indian Billy White Wolf.
As the ring announcer pointed out, White Wolf, the co-holder of the Worldwide Wrestling Federation Tag Team Championship. It's going to be interesting to see what he can do here in individual action as we are indeed set for action. Speed, barely more speed possessed by his opponent, Frank Monroe. Of White Wolf is pretty much of an unorthodox wrestler, and that creates a lot of problems for his opponents. Although Big Frank Monroe appears to be doing quite well for himself at the moment. Monroe carrying the head of White Wolf again into a turnbuckle, and it's all Frank Monroe here at the moment. Frank Monroe all over Billy White Wolf. White Wolf has shown us very little thus far. A third time to the turnbuckle, and White Wolf is dazed. White Wolf with a left hand only a moment ago there to midsection, and Monroe apparently backing up. So White Wolf picking up a bit of momentum, and Frank Monroe stepping to the outside of the ring now, trying to break what momentum Billy White Wolf did possess. White Wolf brings him in the hard way. Big Frank Monroe now one-on-one against White Wolf. Billy White Wolf really has turned things around. Double chop. White Wolf crashing down across the chest. A move that could break someone's sternum down for the count of two. Three, it's all done. Billy White Wolf apparently victorious over Frank Monroe. Things really turned around for White Wolf during the early stages of the match. It was all Frank Monroe. Oh, Monroe apparently doesn't know where he is. Yes, sir, Monroe having a pretty rough go of it. Was worked over quite well in the latter stages there by Billy White Wolf. Let's get the official decision.
The time of the match, 2 minutes, 45 seconds. Here's your winner, Indian Billy White Wolf.
Indian Billy White Wolf victorious over Big Frank Monroe. Let's take a look at some action that we did see during the latter stages of the match here. Now, White Wolf has pretty much patented this maneuver here. It is a crushing blow. White Wolf down right into the chest. If it doesn't knock the wind out of you, it could crush a few ribs. Monroe, a tough customer in his own right, though, able to take the punishment, although we saw the results of the punishment that it was taken after the match was over. White Wolf on the victory. Will return with George the Animal Steel.
The following attraction is all set for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing in the corner to my left, weighing 245 pounds from Ponce, Puerto Rico, Don Serrano. Approaching the ring is the captain, Luis Albano. From Detroit, Michigan, 290 pounds, George Steele.
There he is. There's the animal. Look at the ugly folds of skin on the otherwise bald head of George the Animal Steele. When he takes off his sweatshirt, you'll see that in contrast to his bald head, the rest of his body is covered with, you could almost call it fur. There is so much hair there. Some people feel that George the Animal Steele is a throwback to the Cro-Magnon period, perhaps Neanderthal. He's not all there, that much we can grant you. Steele coming in now, attacking from behind Don Serrano. Apparently Steele biting the forehead, hard right hand. George Steele ready to wrestle Don Serrano. Caught him off guard. George Steele, the most unorthodox wrestler of all time, I believe. Serrano, well-seasoned veteran, knows indeed what he's in for, knows the caliber of George Steele, and we're set for action.
trying to shake off the pressure applied earlier by George Steele, and Steele right back in there. Albino distracting referee Dick Worley, at least doing a good job of trying to do that. And again, George Steele continuing to attack that left arm, and there it is. The flying hammerlock, and it's all over. Just like that, George the Animal Steele able to put young Don Serrano down. Able to make him say uncle. Serrano, look at him. There's the opponent of Don Serrano, George the Animal Steele. It is doubtful as to whether or not even Captain Louis Albano can control this extraordinary athlete.
The time of the match, 2:08. Here's your winner, George Steele.
George the Animal Steele, who from time to time seems to have a fetish for these turnbuckles around the ring. There's a good look at him. George the Animal Steele, accompanied by his manager, Louis Albano. Let's take a look at some action there in the latter stages. Don Serrano here, a fine young man, a darn good wrestler too. A bit overmatched here against this unorthodox animal as George Steele gets behind him, and that's trouble for any wrestler. And what power exhibited by George Steele as Don Serrano goes high in the air, his mouth wide open, submitting just as loud as he can. We shall return with more wrestling action involving the one and only superstar Billy Graham, the current Worldwide Wrestling Federation champion.
Ladies and gentlemen, the next attraction is set for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing in the corner to my left, weighing 221 pounds from Puerto Rico, Mike Madero. And his opponent, 278 pounds from Paradise Valley, Arizona, the newly crowned Worldwide Wrestling Federation heavyweight champion, superstar Billy Graham.
Superstar Billy Graham. There he is, being led by his manager, the Grand Wizard, and there is the Worldwide Wrestling Federation championship belt, worn so proudly all those years by Bruno Sammartino, now around the waist of superstar Graham. As we mentioned before, through the weeks we will be showing you bits of action filmed during that historical championship match that was held in Baltimore when Sammartino was fortunate enough to defeat, well, getting all choked up here. A lot of fans not liking what they see. Graham defeating Sammartino in Baltimore. As we said before, we will have action later on next week and the following weeks concerning the championship match.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is a non-title match.
Non-title match, Graham refusing to put the championship on the line, which is understandable to a certain extent. He just won the championship. So therefore, he might be a bit reluctant to put it on the line. And there's the Grand Wizard. Look at the smile and the kisser of the Grand Wizard. The Wizard showing it to everybody. He wants everybody to see. The Wizard apparently not finished yet in preparing superstar for action here on Championship Wrestling. The Wizard rubbing those extraordinary biceps and triceps possessed by Graham. Unquestionably the most impressive physique in all of professional wrestling. A lot of power, a lot of strength in that physique. Not to discount superstar Billy Graham's extraordinary agility and speed.
The Wizard unquestionably taking delight in preparing Graham for combat here. The opponent of Superstar Graham, an individual making his very first appearance, I believe, here, Mike Madero. Finally, we're set for action, and here we go. Just first to the turnbuckle. Graham sending him to the near side. Looks like he scraped the entire length of his face then. Madero on the canvas, and Graham wants to keep him there, apparently. Madero scooped up like a fly, hammered down to the canvas. Forearm smash across the back of young Mike Madero as Madero again finds his way down to the canvas. Thus far, this match has been 1,000% Graham. Madero over the top rope. Graham, perhaps the most controversial athlete in all the professional wrestling today, especially since winning that championship. Graham does have a quite a large contingent of fans. Madero now over the top rope again and down hard on the concrete floor. Madero getting up very, very slowly now on his feet. Graham reaching for two handfuls of hair. Snaps Madero into the ring. Madero whipped to the ropes, waiting for it. There, Superstar Graham takes him down to the canvas again. Graham down for the cover in the count of one, count of two, and it's all over. Superstar Graham chalks up a victory for himself, his first victory on championship wrestling since winning the coveted championship from Bruno Sammartino.
The time of the match, 2 minutes, 17 seconds. Here's your winner, Superstar Billy Graham.
Superstar Graham, the newly crowned Worldwide Wrestling Federation champion, victorious. We shall return with the tag team match of Larry Zbysko and Tony Garea against Stan the Man Stasiak, his partner, Baron von Raschke.
Is this the final event? It is set for one fall or to the curfew. Introducing, in the corner to my right, from Buzzards Creek, Oregon, weighing 272 pounds, the former world's champion, Stan the Man Stasiak. And his partner, representing Nuremberg, Germany, weighing 274 pounds, the European heavyweight champion, Baron von Raschke. And their opponents, from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, 244 pounds, Larry Zbysko. And his partner, from Auckland, New Zealand, 252 pounds, Tony Garea.
So, we've set the stage here for quite a tremendous tag team match to wind things up this week as we're set for action.
I'll tell Gary later. I made a mistake.
The man, Stan the man, hanging on. Hard right hand there into the left pectoral muscle of Larry Zbyszko. Nice reversal by Larry Zbyszko and a double reversal. Is Stasiak, no, Zbyszko back. Tag made, and here comes the big Baron. Tying up now. Zbyszko backed up against the rope. Von Raschke hanging on to the left arm. Hammering away on the back of the neck. Baron Von Raschke going to work now on Larry Zbyszko. Same hold it was applied by Stan the Man only earlier. And again, they're starting to work on that left pectoral muscle of Zbyszko. Von Raschke noted principally for his brain claw, not to discount other holds possessed by Von Raschke. Quite a versatile athlete here, this Von Raschke. And thus far, Von Raschke and Stan the Man are undefeated on championship wrestling. Unquestionably, something has to give here because so are their opponents undefeated. Zbyszko and Tony Garea. Missed with a tag, and if this keeps up, then Zbyszko and Garea will no longer go undefeated. Stasiak and Von Raschke are doing a good job of what, a fundamental maneuver in tag team efforts, and that is to keep one of your opponents from tagging his tag team partner. Keep it two on one, which is what Von Raschke and Stasiak have done thus far. Zbyszko doing his best to get out of there. But Raschke really hanging on. Raschke shoved to the ropes. Zbyszko reels him off this time. Back body drop. All right, taken down Von Raschke. Falling over. Here comes the tag. Stay the man. Raschke to the corner. Back out. Back body drop. Garea, house of fire at the moment. Scoops his man up, turns him around, and hammers him down to the canvas. Over for the cover, one. That's all he can get. Raschke certainly proving he's a tough customer in his own right. Von Raschke whipped to the ropes again, this time. It's Garea who comes out on the short end of that stick. As Stan the Man steps into the ring. Tony head first to the turnbuckle, down back to the canvas. Right hand again by Stan the Man Stasiak. So once again, here it is again. A heart, no. Rhea ducking just in the nick of time as Stasiak pummeled the turnbuckle cover, tag made. Von Raschke coming through. Von Raschke taking up right where Stasiak left off. Garea whipped to the ropes. Von Raschke waiting for him. Measuring him down. No, missing. Garea trying to make his way over to tag Zbyszko. He just made it in the nick of time. Oh, trouble. Whip to the ropes, Von Raschke, knee finding against Mark. Von Raschke locked in the ropes. Stasiak locked in the ropes. Hey, what's gonna happen now? Down to the midsection. Garea doing the same thing.
more time.
It looks like more double punishment here. Von Raschke doesn't want to let go of the rope, and now Garanz and Misko have him crashing into his tag team partner. And that, in addition to being painful, must be a somewhat humiliating experience. Right hand. Turn things right back around. Stasiak, a very powerful man. Another right hand against the forehead, down to the canvas, over for the cover. Referee down with one, two. And Tony Garea comes in to help out his partner, Larry Zbyszko. Zbyszko through the ropes on the outside. Zbyszko holding his forehead, trying to shake the cobwebs out. Appears to be dazed. Tony Garea's partner coming over to help him now. Referee continuing the count. Zbyszko rolling through the ropes just in the nick of time before being counted out. Tag made. Von Raschke stepping through. Zbyszko down to the knee of Stan the Man. Von Raschke drops him like a bag of potatoes on the canvas. Tag made. Frequent tag made here by Von Raschke and Stan the Man. Double kick to the chest. That'll certainly take its toll on Larry Zbyszko. Missing with a heart punch again. Stan the Man measured Zbyszko. Zbyszko at that moment was motionless. But just when Stasiak reared back to let him have it, on the way down, Zbyszko moving out just in the nick of time. So Zbyszko saving himself from that devastating heart punch. Larry, chest first to the turnbuckle. Zbyszko trying to counter. Slinging those roundhouse rights to the midsection. Tag made, Von Raschke stepping through. The tag was not made over there by Garea. Both individuals in the ring at the same time. Both going to work on Tony Garea's in there as well. Oh, look at that. Pandemonium has broken loose here at the arena. The fans on their feet. Back of the ring, Zbyszko and Garea. I don't know whether they were victorious or not. Let's get the official word.
Ladies and gentlemen, after wrestling to curfew, the official decision is a draw. Draw.
They wrestled to curfew. The official decision was a draw. Let's take a look at some action we saw there in the latter stages of this match, although the crowd here thinks Zbyszko and Garea apparently won. Here, hammering away now. Three wrestlers in the ring at the same time. Well, Tony Garea, not to be left out, also enters to save his tag team partner, Larry Zbyszko, from apparent destruction. So here they go round and round. But here we see teamwork on the part of Zbyszko and Garea. They'll go round and round here in a bit of a do-si-do and come right back around and say hello to their opponents. Next week, ladies and gentlemen, a special ladies match. Kitty Adams will meet Sheila Shepherd. Also scheduled, S.D. Jones meeting the individual who claims to be the strongest human being on Earth, Ken Patera, and more of the historic championship match that took place in Baltimore, Bruno Sammartino against superstar Billy Graham.
In We Bought a Zoo.
The sellers say-